This beautiful anthropoid outer coffin belongs to a yellow coffin type originating in the third intermediate period. Its owner is the lady of the house and the songstress of Amun named Nesitau Jetahet. Her name on the lid is almost erased. Perhaps someone wanted to reuse her coffin and write another name instead, which happened quite often. The coffin dating back to the 11th century BC was discovered in Thebes in 1891. It was found among the other mortuary goods of Nesitau Jetahet in the so-called Babel Guzus, or the cache of priests. The French Egyptologist Georges Darcy, the one who discovered it, assigned it to the funerary set A96. In 1893, the coffin came to Odessa at the part of the lot number 6. That was a set of antiquities aimed to be the gift from Khedive of Egypt, Abbas II Hilmi, to the Russian Empire. The coffin is richly decorated with the scenes from the underworld. The colors are as vivid as if it was painted yesterday. These splendid decorations ensure its owner a prosperous existence in the afterlife. Nesitau Jetahet makes offerings to the gods of the great Ennead and worships the Osirite symbol. One of the most important scenes, the judgment of the dead, is placed on the coffin's left side. Here the heart of deceased is being weighed on the divine scales against a feeder of Maat, the goddess of truth. If there will be no balance, the deceased will suffer a second death. But this will not happen, for Nesitau Jetahet is true voice. The coffin's bottom is decorated with the beautiful winged goddess Amentet, she of the west. This protective deity is standing on a hieroglyphic sign meaning gold. On the inner surfaces of the coffin walls are depicted seated mummiform gods and goddesses Isis and Nephthys in the pose of adoration. This bright masterpiece from Theban Funerary Workshop demonstrates the true immortality and delight of ancient Egyptian afterlife.